It's not you. It's me. My needs have changed. I can't deny that anymore. You've been great, really. I don't want you to think that I haven't appreciated everything. It's just, you've been so strong, and you've done everything I've asked of you. But it's over.
Yeah, I'm checking the boulders. Not really. I'm still going to use my boulders, particularly my commander boulders, definitely my prisms. And I'll find uses for the others as well, but it's the mainstay. It is the staple. It is the 80 plus boulder that I'm setting aside. Now, why? Why would I do this after how many years of just talking about how amazing these things are and just how strong they are? You know, like, look at this one. This one, like, look at it. It is just, it is beat to hell and back. I loved these things. But it's time to let them go. And the reason is my needs have changed. The reason why the boulders were so appealing to me was because the main way that I would play Magic is I would go over to a buddy's house, we'd sit on his back porch or in his garage, and we'd just jam games all night, which meant that I wasn't moving around. My chair was my chair for the night. The photography bag that I've shown you multiple times was just perfect for that. I would just fill it full of these, and I had my dice tray, and I would go and play games. The problem is I'm playing differently now. Yeah, sometimes I still go over to my buddy's house and we play deep into the night. The main way I play is going to draft or playing in a modern tournament or maybe Legacy if I can ever get the deck put together. Wonder if the second mortgage has gone through. When I play games now, I sit down at a table, I go through a round, whether it's a draft or a round in the draft, and then when I'm done, I have to pack up and move. I don't really want to have to be pulling out multiple things if I can avoid it. But I've started looking at options like these. In particular, this is the Ultra Pro Alcove. I decided to pick it up for my modern deck because not only is it a faux suede blue, which I like, it also has a dice tray. That's one less thing I have to worry about with this deck. So I just throw in a set of dice that will just forever be with this deck, and I'm good to go. And this can fit in any extra tokens I need for the deck. While these are great, the convenience that I get in things like twin flipping trays, satin towers, alcoves, I can't pass them up. I have to go with them, because they make a nice little package that I don't have to worry about digging through my dice tray. While these things may seem tiny, little tricks like that make life so much easier. And I really do recommend the alcoves. They're cheap. These magnets are strong. Okay, these magnets are kind of almost overkill strong. And I do really like the hidden dice tray that's in here. So I recommend the alcove if you want to check it out. I didn't want to let that be the video that I'm not using boulders. So I decided to add another little idea in that I had while I was looking at these. With Jumpstart, we always talk about Jumpstart battle boxes or battle chests where you put a whole bunch of Jumpstart packs into something and you carry it someplace and then you and your friends pull out a couple of packs and go to town. This works great when you're at home and you have friends come over. But it's not exactly convenient to be carrying this around. One of the draws of Jumpstart is, unlike Draft, you don't need seven other people to run a night of Jumpstart. You just need one other person. So what's the point in lugging an entire box filled with Jumpstart packs when you might use eight of them at most? So I thought, Jumpstart to go. Use these boxes like an alcove. Dice tray included. And if you want the variety, then have your bigger box at home that you can swap the packs out. An alcove can hold five. I recognize that that's one extra than you really need, but instead you can put in infinitokens. And here is a couple of games of Jumpstart right here. What if you have multiple friends that are gonna be at this event? These can hold six apiece. That's three separate decks, actually many more than that if you mix and match, in each of these containers, because you can put one in each. You can give your friend one, you get one, and that's your night of gaming. And again, you've got the dice tray in the middle for any dice, life counters, whatever you want. Sometimes you don't want to be carrying around a massive box full of Jumpstart packs. Options, people. That's what I'm giving you. Options. Follow me on TikTok and Twitter at FDS_MTG and click on that. I'm such a dork. This show is part of the CIP Network, inspiring creativity one episode at a time.